Dr. Cook, thank you for being here today.
Thank you so much for inviting me.
Throughout history, the vast majority of elected or appointed leaders have been men, and women have traditionally been excluded from official leadership roles by law and social costumes. Even in 20th century America, Eleanor Roosevelt's gender constrained her to serve her country in the role of First Lady rather than the President. How did she work within these constraints as a leader, and how much more could she have done had she been elected president?
Well, let me answer that in two ways. One, Eleanor Roosevelt was, above all, a journalist and a community organizer. And in the 1920s, even before women had the right to vote, she went door to door, block by block, community by community, to build movements. And Eleanor Roosevelt believed that the world would be a better place and would change profoundly if women had power. So her vision and her activities were to get women to vote and to get women elected to office. But she herself did not want to be elected to office. Eleanor Roosevelt said, "I would rather be chloroformed than run for office." Wow. But because she wanted to be free, and she wanted to be a journalist and a writer, which is what she was, and an organizer.
Yeah, that's wonderful. Well, thank you for sharing that. Building on Eleanor Roosevelt's legacy, would you please share how she started to create opportunities for women and how her legacy continues today?
Well, it's really wonderful because she is the creator of the Women's Democratic Party Caucus and the Women's Committee. So her legacy is building movements. Her legacy is ending discrimination and bigotry and limitations on democracy. The right to vote had to be for everyone. You know, this is her work in the 40s and 50s against the poll tax. You know, as long as there was a poll tax, only about 9% of the people who could vote would vote. Even, I mean, women didn't vote because their husbands voted. Why pay two poll taxes?
Exactly.
And then there was the really bigoted literacy test. So how long and how ongoing is voter suppression? And this is what Eleanor Roosevelt fought against.
Well, thank you for sharing that. During the recent midterm elections, more women have been elected to the U.S. House of Representatives than ever before in the history of the United States. Do you think Eleanor's work contributed to that in any way?
Well, hopefully all of the new representatives will have Eleanor Roosevelt's, you know, words to lead them on and encourage them. Eleanor Roosevelt always said, "Courage can be as contagious as fear." And then we have to talk with one another. We have to speak with one another whether we agree or not. And all of her messages for how to be in a war-torn world, for how to be in a divided Congress is so important. And so her words are really for this moment.
As a woman from Afghanistan, I have come to see similar patterns in some of the treatment of women in the United States and Afghanistan. Could you share about how inclusive is American democracy, given that women comprise approximately 50% of the US population, but hold relatively few leadership positions in the government?
Well, I think your point is really right on target. We are as sexist as we are racist. And the gender discrimination is ongoing. You know, there's something called Eleanor's Legacy, a wonderful organization that really supports women who are running for political office. And Eleanor Roosevelt, who was orphaned so very young, she had a teacher who said, you are a great writer, you must be independent, be bold, you can do anything you want, and it was her teacher. So we need support, we need mentors, we need encouragement.
Exactly.
And, you know, we can go out and fight. Be bold.
Be bold. No, that's a great way to put it. Be bold.
Be bold.